So here I have what remains of the 1975 four-horse. So, we know it's got a bad top cylinder, so I might as well take it apart and see if we can guess as to what happened to it. My guess is it overheated, given the condition of the cylinder head paint here. But I've known to be wrong on that a few times. I'm going to take the starter off. I'm going to do that a little differently than I usually would. So, I'm going to cut the nut off. And hold the rope right there. The handle off. Try to get that back through. Apparently this isn't going to work as I thought it was going to. Alright, screw it. That didn't retract the knife. Anyway, my plan is to get the starter off kind of in one piece still. That way if I ever need it again, I still haven't done enough to mess with rewinding it. So I got the back pulled off, the handle off. The only thing holding it on now is this 5/8 nut bolt. Now I'm going to try to find a nut again, put it on the back side, and in theory keep this thing all nice and wound for me should I ever need it again. You know what I mean? Put the starter off, carburetor off, fuel lines off. There's really not much left holding this thing together. I've got to undo these clips there. That'll get my throttle linkage disconnected. So that's disconnected and free of itself. Doesn't look like that attaches anywhere. So now it's just the power head mounting bolts. So I'm going to take off these bolts first. Shouldn't be too bad. And the right angle should be able to come right out of there. Alright, with those four bolts out, you should be able to remove the entire lower pan here. So the exhaust tube and water pickup came with it, as it should have. Can't see. There, see? Alright, now, gotta get this gasket off here. By the way, it's like a $10 gasket. Alright. So, flathead. So we're gonna need some flathead tools here. Alright, I have a flathead socket. The breaking loose with that. I have no objection to using the impact wrench here either. Alright, those are all broken loose. So, with all the bolts out, I should be able to pry this power head right out of here. There is still a gasket holding it to the lower pan, so it may still not be that easy, but there we go. That's the lower pan with the power head removed. Alright, to get the flywheel off, we need a puller. Going the right way. And I will be using air tools for this. So the flywheel nut is off. Get the spacer, attach the flywheel puller, looks like this bolt's giving me a little bit of trouble. Not bad enough to where I need to tap it, but I'll use a wrench on it. Well, pretty nice coils, actually. Well, I'll pull the puller off now. Flywheel off, I can pull this back nut off to get the... So that broke, so that's pretty uncool. But got the clamp off there. So
as long as I got the air cools out, might as well use them.
We got four Phillips screws inside of here. They all gotta come off. Ignition plate to come off and off. Off and out. Coils, I mean, they're, you know, early 90s vintage, but they don't really look too bad. I know they got some cracking, but they probably work. Brass plate, it's got to come off. Alright, that is off. Look at that tiny little power head, too. Tiny. Yeah. So we got a broken nut bolt on the cylinder head. Hopefully we don't have any more. Don't really know what happened there. Alright, got the air compressor hooked back up. Looks like one broken bolt, so cylinder head shouldn't give us too many problems coming apart. None at all. Maybe we'll find that. Nope. So far the internals are pretty much what you'd expect. Nothing really noticeably wrong so far. Let's see how it goes though. These have these little keepers. Okay. Bend those back a little. The screw can come out. These don't look too bad. Looks like they're coming out without them. No rollers. Just bushings. Heh! Well, that's a good looking piston, huh? Yep. So, yep, that needed to be replaced. Now, the wall itself. The wall itself isn't really that bad. Kind of nice. You see a little bit of scoring down towards the bottom down there. But tops, really not too bad, and you still see plenty of cross-hatching too. So, said my guess was it overheated. And looks like a decently low-hour freshwater motor, so kind of a shame. I'm going to put the rod caps back together so they don't get confused. I'm going to go ahead and get the bottom off. crank looks okay. Yep, bottom piston looks, looks alright. Used, obviously, but not too shabby.